This video is going to take us through the third of our After Effects Basic series. And what we're going to do here is we're going to work a little bit more in 3D, and we're going to talk about Z-space and cameras. We're going to talk about working with pre-compositions, which we've talked about a little bit before when we brought one composition into another composition, but I'm going to show you some kind of interesting ways of doing that. And then I'm going to talk to you about creating graphs and about animating a logo, although in this case, I'm not actually going to redo this work. I'm just going to have you refer to other YouTube videos, and I'll put those online for you so you can see them. But it gives you a pie chart, a bar graph, and a line graph, as well as shows you how to pull apart a logo in Photoshop and how to then animate that logo in three dimensions. Okay, so the first thing we're going to do is we're going to talk about working in 3D with Z-space and with cameras. So let's talk about how 3D works, and I'm going to refer you to the way you might have done things in middle school or high school. So I'm going to create a new composition first, just because I want things to be clear. So I'm going to do sample for class 3D. Same settings, 0 seconds, 30 duration, full from 0 to 30, and then full resolution. Okay, so now I've got these three compositions in here. So for this comp, what I'm going to do is I'm going to create a new solid. Actually, I'm going to just drag this white solid. It doesn't matter what color it is, so I'm going to drag that down into my timeline. And notice you can drag it down here into your workspace, into your timeline, or you can drag it into your workspace itself up here. So I've got this this solid here, and I'm going to add an effect that I showed you guys before, which was in generate and then grid. And I'm going to make this a little smaller to make the graph. Now let's actually make this whole thing a little smaller. Okay, so we've got a graph here. Maybe I'll make the grid a little bit bigger so it's easier to see. Okay, so this is X and Y space, right? If I go to my position and I change it, I've got my X space, which moves it back and forth, and then I've got my Y space, which moves it up and down, okay? And that's pretty simple, pretty easy to understand, right? What I'm gonna do, though, is make another kind of space that is Z space, which is coming closer to us or further away from us, so making this three dimensions. So the way I have to do this is actually make this into a three-dimensional layer. And that's by clicking on this button here, which has a little cube. That makes it a 3D layer. I'm gonna go ahead and do that because I'm not gonna move this one, but I might want to move it later on. But let's say I wanna move it in Z, and you'll notice that now I've got a whole bunch of other options here. So I've got, if I press P for position, I have my X, right, back and forth, my Y, up and down, and then I've got Z, which is closer to me or further away from me. And notice that it actually does this in perspective. Now, when you look on your screen here, you've got a yellow arrow, which is Y, the red arrow, which is X. And you can see if I hover over it, it gives me a little X there. And then in the middle, there's a little blue dot, and that's Z. Actually, that's an arrow, and if I change to a different view, you can see that. So I'm gonna change my view here from my active camera to custom view one, which is going to send me into kind of an off the side view of this composition. So notice that this black is just negative space. There's nothing there. Even though it looks like there's a black solid there, there isn't. And then I'm gonna click up here on my camera tool, and I'm going to just click and drag around, and you can see that I can move this around in space. And so what we've got here is my y-axis going up and down, my x-axis going left and right, and then I've got my blue axis, which is my Z, going forward and backward. So I'm going to go back to my active camera, which is always this kind of front-on view. And let's make another layer here that is a layer that's coming towards us. So I'm gonna duplicate this. You can right click on this, which actually doesn't work. So I'm just gonna, you can go to, I think it's in layer duplicate, or it might be in composition duplicate. It is in composition duplicate, and I always just use the hotkey, which is Control D or Command D on a Mac. So I'm gonna just do Control D, and now I've got two of these solids. One is on top of one another. You can't really see that, obviously, because they're right on top of one another. So what I'm gonna do is on this top one, I'm going to rename that grid XY, and on this one I'm gonna rename it to grid XZ. So it's gonna be on the X-axis and the Z-axis, right? And so I'm going to then take this and then rotate it. I'm gonna press R. And then I've got my X rotation, my Y rotation, and my Z rotation. Now, this is important to note that I'm going to rotate around an axis. So if I want this grid to come towards me 90 degrees, right, and I want it to be on the flat end, I need to rotate around my X-axis, which is going this way, back and forth, right, like this. If I want it to rotate towards me going up and down, I rotate around my Y-axis. So you can see here, if I'm rotating around my Y-axis, it moves it that way, right, which is not what I want. And on the Z-axis, it's rotating it around that space, so it's changing it on the X layer. So what I want to do is on the X-axis, and you can move it, and you can see that it actually looks like it's coming towards you. And what I'm going to do here is actually type in 90 degrees, because I want it to be completely flat. Now, one of the issues with this, and we can see this if we go to our custom view, you can see what it actually looks like. Now, if I wanted to use this as a graph, it doesn't look all that great, and the reason is that it's too high. So I'm going to go back to my active camera, and I want to move this down. So I'm going to press P, go to position, and then I'm going to move it down in Y space until it's at the bottom here. And that is going to give me my my grid. Now, you can see, again, this doesn't quite look perfect, and there's a couple of reasons for that. But the main reason for it is that this is the center of the grid and not the bottom of the grid, and so I just have to move it closer to me to actually make this work. So I can move it towards me in Z space or away from me in C space or whatever. So the easiest thing to do here again is to go to your custom view. And you can zoom in a little bit. And I'm pressing spacebar here to move it around. And now I can go through and I can change my my X, Y, and Z space. So I'm going to move it so that it's at the edge here. And let's actually have it connect there. And you can see on the, it's not quite lining up, right, in different spots. But that's, I think, a matter of the perspective. So let's raise it up a little bit. So that just gives us pretty close to what we're looking for in a grid. So if we go back to, I'll just zoom out here, and I'm gonna grab my camera, and I'm going to rotate around. So that gives us our grid, and you can see it's not quite perfect because I've got these pieces on the other end. So let's say I wanna grab the Y-axis, and I can drag it forward a little bit so that it's a little closer there. You know, there's all sorts of things that you can do here to make it look exactly like you want it to look. So for right now, I think this is okay. And what I want to do is show you that you can then create a space with this area. It's useful to see it in a grid, but I really want to create a kind of three-dimensional space here. And we're going to work with grids more in the graph, so I'm not really going to worry about this. So I'm gonna make these invisible. And what I wanna do here is create a solid. Let's just create a place to play in, basically. So I'm going to grab another solid, and I'm gonna drag it on top. And I'm gonna go back to my active camera so that I can really see what I've got here. And I'm gonna zoom out, go to fit. Okay, so this is my active camera here, and maybe I want to tint this, so I'll add an effect, and I want to change the color, and that's in color correction. Notice I'm selected, I have to be selected on my layer. So effect, color correction, and then tint. And then I can go through and I'm gonna change my white to, I don't know, maybe a blue or something. Okay, so now I've got a tinted solid here. And yes, of course, I could make a new solid here that's blue, but I would like to be able to change it really easily, so I'm just gonna go ahead and map it to a different space. Okay, so I can create another one if I want to, obviously, that's coming towards me, but I think before that point, what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna make this 3D, and let's rotate it on the, so I'm gonna press R, and I'm gonna rotate it on the x-axis towards us. So let's do it at 90 degrees, and you can see it disappears. But let's do it so maybe a little bit less so that we can actually see it without messing with our camera. So let's do it to 80 degrees. Oh, actually, it has to be the other way. So 110 degrees. Okay, so now if we go to that camera, you can see that I've got this tilted down a solid here. Okay, so what I want to do is I want to create a set of spaces on this that I want to move through. So actually, let's make this less visible so we don't have to worry about it. Okay, so now it's in my middle spot here, and I'm going to drag this down in position to a little bit lower. Just so that we can actually work. And I'm going to create some new layers here. So I'm going to create a new, actually let's just, I'll do it with shapes. So I'm going to create a shape, I'm going to click out, create a shape, and then let's say I want to create something that might look like a building or something, right? So I'm going to create a little building, and let's say it looks like that. Okay, so that's kind of cool. And let's make some windows on that building. I'm going to go ahead and just add another shape. So I'm clicking out, then I'm going to add a small shape that is a little window here. And I'm going to change that fill to black. So I'm going to select out. You can see that what I've done is I've got a little white outline and I've got my fill. Okay, so this doesn't look the way I want it to look exactly, so I'm going to go through and change this around a little bit. But notice my anchor point isn't in here. The anchor point's all the way over here, so I'm gonna move my anchor point first so that it's on top of my piece, and then I can zoom in, and then I can start messing with scale here. So I'm gonna make this a little larger so that it actually looks like a window. Okay, so that's kinda cool. Not exactly what I might wanna go for, but I think for now it's okay. So let's say I just wanted to do three of those or two of those all the way on. Now remember, I can duplicate this. So I simply go to Edit, Duplicate, or Control D, and then I can move this around. And remember, Shift allows me to keep it in the same spot, basically. So we're pretty close there. And I look a little bit too much like a monster here, so maybe I'll grab these two and then Command D or Control D to duplicate them again. So now I've got four, oops, of those. And then I can keep duplicating this. So I mean, again, I could do this with each one individually, or I could do all four of these, and then Control D to duplicate them, and I can drag them down again. So that looks kind of like an apartment building, and then maybe you would put like a door or something down there. You know, whatever you want to do, this is just a graphical representation. So that's one way to do it, and that seems to me a little clumsy, right? So let's make another one here. I'm gonna make a new shape layer. I'm gonna click out here and deselect, and then I'm gonna create a new shape, and let's make it the same thing. So I'm gonna have the fill be the same gray, and now let's make a new one. And I know we did this before, but it'll give you some idea. And of course, I could duplicate this layer to have it be the same size if I wanted to, right? I'm not going to worry about that now. But so this gives you an idea. Now in here, I've got, again, rectangle one. So I can always, rather than resize the shape, I can resize the rectangle in here, right? So I can go to transform, and I can go to my scale, and let's say I want to make it a little fatter, I can unchain these, and I can make it a little fatter, et cetera, et cetera, right? So so that's my shape here. Now if I'm back in my shape layer, now let's go ahead and create my new rectangle. So I'm gonna draw another rectangle inside, and you can see that it's the same type, but let's say I wanna make that a little different, then I can go through for rectangle two and make that black, right? And then I can always duplicate this rectangle, right? So control D duplicates it again, and oops. And I can go through and then transform just this one bit of the shape, right? Now, again, the problem is when I'm clicking in here, it's not actually changing the rectangle itself. So I'd want to go through and go to transform and change my position on the x-axis. And then, of course, you could go through and take rectangle 2 and 3 and duplicate those, and then go to position, right? Oops. So now I've got contents. So now I've got rectangle 5, and I want to move this down on Y, and then I think I've got it on rectangle 3. Although I'm not positive about this. Oops, nope. So I want to go to probably rectangle 4 here. And I can move this down as well. And then again, I can duplicate those, et cetera, et cetera, et cetera. And so make the same effect basically, but all within the same shape layer. And that's one way to do it, right? So now if I move the shape layer back and forth in Z space, it will simply make another building, or sorry, it'll make the whole thing move at once. Now, again, that's one way to do it. Now, if you like to work with all the different shape layers, that's fine. And you can actually, it gives you a little bit more freedom to play with things. I think it makes it a little easier to work with sometimes, depending on what you're doing here, right? So when I've got all of this, I can highlight all these. So I can click on one and then hold down the shift button and click down here somewhere, right? If I want to do individual layers, I can hold down control or command, right? And on the Mac, and that will allow me to select the individual layers. But so from here, I'm going to hold down shift because they're all together. And what I want to do is right click and go to pre-compose. And what this does is I can name this to building. Move all attributes into the new composition, and I think that's fine. We can adjust new composition duration to the time span of selected layers if you want to, whatever. I'm not going to worry about it. I'm just going to click OK. And what that does is it makes basically all of that into a single layer called building. That, notice, you can also transform. So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to double click this so it opens it, and now I've got my building layer, and I can change these, so I can change all of the strokes for this. So I'm gonna grab my select tool and change all of these to maybe a 1 pixel stroke instead of a 2 pixel stroke. I can change the color, I can do all sorts of things in here if I want to. And when I've done this, the really cool thing about this is that I have all these, this building that I can then duplicate over and over and over again. So I can take this piece and I'm gonna go ahead and make this into 3D so that it moves back and forth. And notice when I did that, it actually disappeared behind this layer. I don't know if you can see that, but I'm gonna go to the camera so you can see it. So what happened is that it's actually behind it. Before, it wasn't three dimensions, so you'd only see it in that one dimension. So you wanna make sure that your layers are all 3D and that they're all kind of connected like this. So I'm going to go back to my active camera, and now I've got this building, and I'm going to duplicate this building. So Command D or Control D, and then I can move the building over. And what I'm going to do now is move this back in Z space. So let's say I want to leave it exactly where it was, but I want to move it back in Z space. So I'm going to press P and change it to, I don't know, negative 50 or something. Maybe I'll make it even bigger here. So negative, 200. So now I've got a really cool thing here where I've got these buildings that are basically become a grid. And of course I can highlight both of these again and duplicate these, and I can move them to the side. So if I want to press position, I can move them over along the x-axis, and suddenly I've got streets and alleys, right? And what's amazing about this is that, again, I can go through and put all of these. So let's say I've got this as a city block. I can go through and I can pre-compose all of these. So I've got one composition nested into another composition nested into another composition, right? So I've got one composition that is my city block, or one composition that's my building, which is a bunch of shapes. Then I've got my city block, and then I've got them all in this one space. And I can, again, duplicate this and move it around into three-dimensional space. So let's say I want to move this again on my x-axis, so like that, right? And then maybe I will make another one, and I'm going to go to position and move this back in Z space. So you get all sorts of really, really interesting pieces here. In fact, maybe I'll do both of these, and I'll duplicate them, and I will move them in Z space. Okay, actually, not sure what happened there. Okay, so that's I think that's right on top of it. So, all right. So we got that on the left, that on the right. So I'm going to take both of these and duplicate them, go to position, and then move them in Z space. So they're forward. So now again, if I go into my custom view and click on my camera tool, I can rotate through and you can see what this actually looks like in three-dimensional space. I'm going to zoom out here so you can see it. So notice that these are flat. If I want to make them really come alive, so you can see my city block here, these are all three dimensions, and you know. So what's up with this is that it's not actually seeing it as part of the piece, because it's one composition and another composition. So what I want to do is actually click on this little button here, which is my collapse transformation button. And what this does is it actually connects everything in together. So when I move through, I've actually got my pieces in multiples here, right? I've got one block and then I've got another block. And so I can go ahead and I can take this one and I can move it back or whatever. So that's one way to think about your project here. Now I want to show you how to actually move through this. And the way to do that is to go to Layer, New, Camera. And you can create a specific camera and you can choose what type of camera. I like to enable depth of field, which is that things in the background get fuzzy as they're further away or when they're outside of the range of your focus. And you can change all of this stuff to be a different kind of camera. And when you see this, what I've got now is, I'm going to zoom out here, is a virtual camera that's looking at my space. You can see the camera's pointing towards the space. And you can change all sorts of things here. You can change the position of the camera, and you can change where it's looking, right? So if I want to move this camera in, so I'm going to go to camera one. You can see that's what camera one sees. And I can just gonna move this camera up a little bit so that we can see it. So I can actually change my position here. So I'm going to zoom forward a little bit, And maybe I'll zoom down a little bit as well. So I'm going to go back to my custom view one because it allows me to have a little bit more space here. And let's say I want it to be looking down at the, down at my pieces. So let's see how that looks. Right now, camera one looks like that. So I can actually now animate this. So let's say I want to start here. I can actually animate the position of my camera. So let's say at this point we're here, and let's also animate our point of interest. So you can see that that's automatically animated in this case, but you want to have this animated. You're going to be sure to have this animated. So now I'm going to go through, and maybe 4 seconds in or 6 seconds in, I actually want to zoom and move through this, right? So let's say 2 seconds I want to be down here. So I'm going to move my camera down or over here. And I want to move it down in space. And I'm going to move my camera angle up a little bit. And I will keep moving down in space here and the camera angle up until it looks exactly how I want it to look. So notice I'm basically creating a little cityscape here. And then let's say I want to actually move forward in space. Okay, so you can see that each time I have to adjust this. Okay, so now what's going to happen is as I start, I'm actually going to move just like this is a three-dimensional space and move in, right? And now I can continue. I can go through and I can move in. And I can change my my point of interest to be in the middle and maybe down a little bit. I'm going to reduce this down to half so it makes it a little faster. And then I want to move through this space. Okay. So now what's going to happen? So I'm going to move down over, and then I'm going to move in, flow into this space. So that's actually not that difficult. Once, what you really have to do is think about what you want it to look like. What do you want to move through? And this could be a network of buildings like this, obviously. But it could be something else entirely. It could be, signs. It could be copy that you move through. And of course, all of these can move as well. So you could have a car moving down here in graphics. You can do some really, really interesting, really complex things. But it doesn't have to be incredibly complex, right? It could just be really kind of playful or interesting or whatever. So that's my intro to ZSpace and cameras. And what I do want to remind you is to look at those other videos on creating graphs and animating a logo, because that will give you a little bit more information here.